is this Tabletop Island home? Let's see what this is all about.
After dragons have finished a meal of intruding humans, the leftover skulls make the perfect pieces for a game known to dragons as Heads Will Roll. You've got to be kidding me.
Yo, you're so trash!
Yo, I can't even see this shot, but judging by this roll, I knew he'd mess this up. I really don't understand how he keeps messing this up. It's in a straight line.
Where is Low-Waste Games even finding these idiots? If I still had a hand, I could have done this.
I'm glad he can't see how disappointed I am right now, because I'm upset. Don't even try fixing it. You've done enough. Just put us back in the backseat. There you go. At least you can do that right.
Welcome to Tabletop Island. I'm Bernard, your host, and today we're going to be taking a look at the board game, wait for it, Heads Will Roll. This is a small, compact game by Low-Waste Games. They actually reached out to me with a review copy, and I'm so glad they did. I've adored every game I've played of theirs thus far, and this one is no exception. It is a very small game that fits in your pocket, which is something I've been looking for a lot as of recent. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's first take a look at the components. So the components here are easy. You have a total of 5 skulls. You have 2 silver human skulls, 2 black human skulls, and you also have the golden human skull. And then finally, you have the dragon skull. Very simplistic. These components are really high quality. They're made of metal here, super solid. They have a decent weight to them, but when they're all together, it doesn't weigh a whole lot, but it is nice, feels great in the hand, and man, is this such a simplistic idea. When I first opened it up and I saw it, I was like, that's weird. So just all of these pieces, and I was looking through the rules, I was like, I'm not too certain what this is going to be about. Let's try it out. We jumped into it, and man, was I impressed. While the components are simplistic, don't let that fool you, because there's a really solid game built into here. So the premise of the game, you take all of the skulls in your hand, you roll them out onto the table, not being too reckless, because if any of the skulls roll off the table, guess what, your turn's over. So be a little bit careful, and trust me, you also don't want to be too reckless, because you're ultimately going to have to flick the dragon skull to hit the golden skull. Now, while that does seem simplistic enough, and the first player to get to 21 points wins, there are some ways you can get more points. For example, if you have a kind of invisible line is what you're going to be drawing here. If you draw an invisible line between 2 colored skulls of the same color, either 2 black or 2 silver, then you want to essentially flick it through that invisible line to hit the skull. If you do, that is 1 point. Now, if the skulls are orientated the same way, so if they're both pointed upwards, then that is going to be 2 points. And again, if you can get it through 2 invisible lines, that's going to be a lot more points for you. So the most maximum amount of points you can get is going to be 5. 2 if the 2 black skulls are pointed the same way, 2 if the 2 silver skulls are pointed the same way, and then also 1 point for hitting the golden skull. And players take turns constantly rolling the human skulls onto the table and flicking to gain points. The first player to get to 21 points wins. Now, I understand that sounds so simplistic, but man, there's so much here. The flicking while you think, ooh, this is so easy, I got it right here, and it ends up slipping past, happens more than I'd like to admit, and honestly, even with enough practice at this game, you can mess up rather badly because you get too cocky or a little too confident, and you don't focus on the trajectory of how you flick it. And while that sounds easy enough, also the positioning of the kind of dragon skull is also important. Because if you end up having it upside down, we've noticed a lot of times it ends up shooting upwards, which can help for trick shots, but if you're not ready for that, that's not something you want to experiment with, because that can really backfire a lot. Yeah, that's not fun. But there's abundance of different things you can add to the game. One interesting way, that game mode-ish way that I've kind of been playing with too, is rolling all of them together, even with the dragon skull. That way you don't have control as to where you place it, and you're kind of forced to roll or flick it where it lands, which can be ridiculously hard in most cases, which makes it a little bit more exciting when you're a veteran player of the game and you want to add a little bit more spice to this. But it is tricky, so be mindful of that. I think the game's fantastic. It packs small, plays big. In fact, the little bag it comes in fits well in your pocket. It's kind of what I was looking for with kind of Hive Pocket, with having games that I can bring almost anywhere, such as like a beach, a restaurant whenever we can get back to one of those. And, you know, the idea of those pieces, you just wash them off. It's not like a playing card that can get soaked and ruined or whatever it may be. These components are made to last a lifetime, and I love that about this game. Again, it's easy to teach. It's fun for the whole family. And honestly, if you have a surface that you can do this on, even if it's the floor, it doesn't have to be a table. I know the weight of the skulls can be a little tricky. You probably don't want it on your nicest table or even a glass table for that matter. Don't do that. Then this game's going to be perfect for you, and I highly recommend it. Again, thank you so much for checking out this video, and when this game is available, there will be a link in the description where you can purchase this game. I'll also put out an update to in one of my weekly videos as to when it's actually out. I believe they mentioned it's going to be a Kickstarter game, so keep your eyes peeled for that one. Heads Will Roll by Lay Waste Games. But that's honestly all I have for you guys today. If you're interested in notifications, there's a bell up there somewhere, or down there, YouTube changes. Please like, comment, subscribe. I appreciate any feedback. I'm trying to make these videos more and more outrageous, and with your guys' help, I have been doing so. Monday, regular board game reviews. Wednesday, weekly update / talks, and then on Fridays, my vintage board game reviews. That is all I have for you guys today. I'll see you guys next time.